This is Unit 2, Block 4. Today we're going to get started on the shortcut rules. So instead of using limits to find the derivatives, we are going to be able to use shortcuts to identify the exact derivative function. This video, the first video, is going to talk about the shortcut rule for finding the derivative of power functions. So first of all, you need to be able to recognize a power function when you see one. A power function is a function that has the form x raised to a power, x raised to the p, where p is any number. So for example, you could have x to the 7th, so x in the base and the power 7 in the exponent, or x to the negative 4, so x in the base, negative 4 in the exponent, or it could even be fractions in the exponent, like x to the 1/3. Those are just some examples of power functions. So if you have a function of that form, then turns out the derivative of that function is p times x to the p minus 1. So notice what we did there. We took the p, the power, that was the original exponent, p, dropped it down out front. So you drop down the p out front, and then you keep the x in the base, and the new exponent is p minus 1. So new exponent in your derivative, you take the original p and subtract 1. So let's give it a try. So in our first example, we have the function f of x equals x to the 7th. I see that is definitely a power function, x in the base, 7 in the exponent. So to find the derivative of this, I'm going to drop down the 7. And then I'm going to subtract 1 from the exponent for the new exponent. So it'll be 7 out front, x to the 6th. 7x to the 6th. The next one, f of x equals x to the negative 4. Again, it's x in the base, negative 4 in the exponent. So it's a power function, x raised to a power. The derivative, we drop down the negative 4 out front, and then we take negative 4 minus 1 in the exponent, so negative 5. If we have f of x equals x to the 1/3, again, it's x raised to a power, then we find the derivative by dropping down the exponent, so 1/3 goes out front, times x to the 1/3 minus 1 to get the new exponent. So notice how that would work. 1/3 minus 1. You'll have to get common denominators, so 1/3 minus 3/3. And so you get 1 minus 3 is negative 2, and you keep the base, so negative 2/3 will be your new exponent. So the derivative will be 1/3 x to the negative 2/3. All right, let's try some that are just slightly more complicated. Our next example says that we want to find the derivative of f of x equals x. So notice it doesn't actually look like x to a power, but you can certainly rewrite it so that it looks like x to a power. If it's just y equals x, that's the same as x to the first power. So it's x to the 1. So to find its derivative, we drop the 1 down out front, and then it'll be the new exponent, our derivative will be 1 minus 1. So it'll be 1x to the 0. Remember, x to the 0 power is going to be just 1. So the derivative will just be the number 1. Now notice, we actually could have gotten that just by understanding what the derivative is. Recall, when the derivative is the slope, the instantaneous rate of change. So if I'm asking you to find the derivative of y equals x, y equals x, that is a straight line, a linear function. Another way to write that is y equals 1x plus 0. It's got slope 1 at all times. At any instant on this function, the derivative is 1. Slope is 1, slope is 1, slope is 1. So when I ask what is the function that is the derivative, it's f prime of x equals 1, because the slope is 1. So the shortcut rule gives us that answer, but also just understanding the meaning of the derivative gives us that answer. For the next function, we're given f of x equals the 4th root of x. So again, I'm noticing here that this function does not look like a power function. Remember, a power function is x raised to a number, x raised to a power. But if you recall, we have exponent rules that allow you to rewrite a radical expression using rational exponents. So for example, square root of x is the same thing as x to the 1/2. Cube root of x is the same thing as x to the 1/3. And for this example, fourth root of x is the same thing as x to the 1/4. So when we rewrite it that way, we can clearly see that it is a power function, x raised to the 1/4 power. So to find the derivative, we drop down the 1/4 out front, and then it's x raised to the 1/4 minus 1. So the derivative will be 1/4 x to the 1/4 minus 1. Again, if you need to go off to the side and recall how to do that subtraction of fractions, 1/4 minus 1, we got to get a common denominator, which is 4. So it's really 1/4 minus 4/4. Subtract the numerators, you get negative 3. Keep the denominator, you get 4. So 1/4 minus 1 is negative 3/4. So the derivative is 1/4, drop down out front, x to the negative 3/4. There's the derivative function. All right, in our last example for the power rule, if we have the function f of x equals 1 over x to the 5th, again, does not look like a power function, but we have exponent rules that allow us to rewrite that expression so that it does look like x to a power. So recall, if you have 1 over x, another way to write that is 1 over x to the 1, that is the same thing as flipping that x to the 1 up to the numerator, but then you have to rewrite your exponent as x to the negative 1. X to the negative 1 is the same as 1 over x to the 1. Similarly, 1 over x squared, you can take that x squared, flip it up to the numerator, and write it as x to the negative 2. X to the negative 2 is the same as 1 over x squared. 1 over x to the 3rd, same as x in the numerator raised to the negative 3. So our function, 1 over x to the 5th, is the same as x to the negative 5th. So to find the derivative of that, we drop down the negative 5 out front. Then we take x to the negative 5 minus 1, which will be negative 6. So the derivative will be negative 5 x to the negative 6.